So welcome everyone for coming here today, and thank you very much for coming. It's lovely to see so many of you. I'm Miss Cheriton, and I'm the Mathematics Coordinator here at BSM. So it's nice to see you all here to learn about our Mathematics Passport. For a lot of you, you'll know that it used to be called the Numeracy Passport, but the new curriculum in the UK has now changed, and the wording is now Mathematics. It's no longer Numeracy. Okay, the purpose of today's meeting, to go through a little bit of the changes in the Mathematics Passport, an explanation of how it is taught in class, clarification of the homework, and how you, as lovely parents, can help us at home. So why do we do the Passport? We do it because it links in with the new national curriculum, it boosts the children's mental math skills. It's completely consistent throughout primary school, through Key Stage 1 and into Key Stage 2. And as they then move forward into senior school, it is something that's going to be newly introduced into senior school as well. It's very easy for the children to follow. They know exactly what they're doing. And it consolidates the number skills section of the curriculum. So it does not cover data handling, shape and space, angles, things like that. It's all to do with number. Okay, so how it works. As I just said, it has now been renamed, so it's now the Mathematics Passport, and that is due to the new national curriculum. The stages are now harder. You're going to find that if you've done it with your children in the past, you're going to find that they are going to struggle for a little bit when they first start. It is tougher. The new curriculum has brought concepts much lower down into school now. So concepts that used to be in year 6, for instance, are now being taught in year 4. We've also got the introduction of new topics such as Roman numerals that's come back into our curriculum. The children will receive a homework sheet. It will be levelled for the children's ability, and you'll find that most children within a class will be on a different objective. The idea is that the children will move on to their own ability and at their own speed. And at the end of each week, the children will then be tested in class to see how they're doing with that objective. Okay, you'll have a little look in a moment at what it looks like up close. However, this is a Key Stage 1 meeting, so for year 1s, they will be introduced to the Numeracy or Mathematics Passport this year. And they will eventually, towards the end of the year, be timed, and they will be given 50 seconds to be able to answer as many questions as they can. Then into year 2, the time gets a little bit quicker and they have 40 seconds. And then when they hit Key Stage 2, they have 30 seconds. It does go quite quickly, but you'll find the children adjust to it quite quickly as well. Topics such as time, as in reading the time from an analogue or digital clock, and timetables such as bus timetables, train timetables, they're not timed because to answer those questions take them a little bit longer. So this here is an example of a class sheet with the 4 quadrants. You'll be able to distinguish between the class sheets and your homework sheets. This is a class one. They'll be in black and white for the children, but they've got numbers around the outside, and this is the type of sheet that they will have only in class.